As you may have heard, the Kansas City Chiefs and the San Francisco 49ers played a football game the other night, and since the Patriots weren't in it, you might have been paying more attention than usual to the TV commercials.
We certainly were, and we were not surprised when the most popular commercial in the USA Today ad meter ranking was the Jeep ad featuring Bill Murray returning to Groundhog Day.
Phil? Hey, Phil!
No, not you.
It's me, man, Ryerson!
Now, part of what made Groundhog Day a classic and what made that commercial so good was the performance of Stephen Tobolowsky, the actor who played Ned Ryerson.
It was really cool to see him pop up in that ad because we interviewed Stephen Tobolowsky for 207 just over a year ago. He was enormously entertaining, and he told us a story about something that happened during the shooting of the movie, a decision that he thought helped transform the film from a good comedy into a great one.
The scene with Bill and I, we began shooting that street scene, the first shot, the first day.
Ned Ryerson, I did the whistling belly button trick at the high school talent show. Bing! Ned Ryerson got the shingles real bad senior year, almost didn't graduate. Bing! Again! Ned Ryerson, I dated your sister Mary Pat a couple times till you told me not to anymore. Well?
Ned Ryerson? Bing!
Near the end of that first week, Harold Ramis shot an enormously complicated scene in which Bill realizes that time has stopped and he has no consequences. And in this scene, Bill spray paints the in-room, the bedroom he's in, takes a chainsaw, cuts the furniture and the bed into, cuts his hair into a mohawk. You know, he does all these crazy things in the room, and then he knows, I think maybe the only part of that that still exists is when he tries to electrocute himself. You know, he, and then he knows that he's going to wake up and Sonny and Cher is going on. This was an enormously expensive scene to do because, of course, in movies, anything you paint, you have to unpaint. Anything you cut in two, you have to have doubles and triples. Just the mohawk haircut cost, that to pay cost $10,000. Harold Ramis, in an act of unbelievable courage in any age, took a look at the footage, threw it away. And he said to Danny Rubin, who the screenwriter of Groundhog Day, he says, what story are we telling? What story are we telling? And Harold Ramis changed that wild, crazy scene to a scene instead where Bill Murray breaks a pencil, puts half of it on the bedside table, half of it on the clock radio, goes to sleep, and in the morning, Sonny and Cher plays, and he opens his eyes, and the pencil is whole. And when I saw that in the movie theater, the audiences gasped. They didn't need all of that stuff. Harold Ramis and Danny Rubin were able to take out all the chaos of the film and replace it with poetry.
Love that story. So, as we said, the Jeep / Groundhog Day commercial was rated number one in the USA Today survey of all 62 ads that aired during the Super Bowl.
That is pretty impressive. Now, the second most popular commercial was this one from Hyundai.
Look who's got Smart Pack.
Smart Pack?
Just hit the clicker, car packs itself.
It's smart.
It's wicked smart. And I can pack it anywhere.
How about Dorchester?
Packed it.
Foxborough?
Packed it.
The Garden?
Packed it.
Saugus?
Packed it.
Swampscott?
Revere?
The Harbor?
Are you kidding me? I packed it and then unpacked it.
You unpacked it?
Kid.
Game changer.
That Sonata ain't got no driver.
I loved that one. If you're a devoted viewer of 207, you might have recognized the last guy, the one who says that Sonata ain't got no driver.
Good delivery.
He's stand-up comedian Tony B, who has performed many times in Maine.
And as you may have guessed, he has appeared frequently on 207 over the years. In fact, he joined me about 5 years ago on a visit to the pier in Old Orchard Beach.
So we're at the Henna Tattoo Shop on the pier at Old Orchard Beach, which, by the way, did you know this? The Pilgrims, when they came to America, they landed here first.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, too many Canadians, they went home.
That's funny.
It's funny. That's what we do.
So there you have them, the two highest rated commercials of the 62 that aired during the Super Bowl. Both of them featured guests we've had on 207. And when Tony was done explaining about the pilgrims coming to Old Orchard Beach, he went up to the lifeguard stand there on the beach and spent a little quality time up there on the night shift.
Oh, good. Good. So he didn't have to do any rescuing.
It was cool, though, to see those two guys who have a nice 207 connection in a, we didn't know this when we first came up with the idea. The two most popular commercials of the 62 that ran.
That is cool.